వెల్కమ్ టు ఓపెన్ హార్ట్. నమస్తే అసదుద్దీన్ గారు.
థ్యాంక్ యూ.
ఎలా ఉన్నారు?
ఫైన్ సార్. బాస్,
మీ బ్రదరు జైల్లో ఉన్నాడు కదా, టెన్షన్ అని ఫీల్ అవుతున్నారా?
నో నో నో, దీస్ ఆర్ పార్ట్ అండ్ పార్సల్ ఆఫ్ పొలిటికల్ లైఫ్, అప్స్ అండ్ డౌన్స్ ఆఫ్ పొలిటికల్ లైఫ్.
బట్ ఆల్రెడీ 1 మంత్ అయిపోయింది.
డజంట్ మ్యాటర్ సార్. మై గ్రాండ్ ఫాదర్ వాజ్ ఇన్ ప్రిజన్ ఫర్ 11 మంత్స్. మై ఫాదర్ గో టు ప్రిజన్ మెనీ టైమ్స్. సో ఇన్ పొలిటికల్ లైఫ్ వన్ కెనాట్ రన్ అవే ఫ్రమ్ సచ్ హ్యాజర్డ్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ దేర్.
అది మంచికి అయితే పర్లేదు, ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఫర్ గుడ్ థింగ్స్.
బట్ ఐ డిసగ్రీ విత్ యూ. హీ ఈస్ ఇన్నోసెంట్ అంటిల్ ప్రూవెన్ గిల్టీ,
ఆఫ్ కోర్స్.
అండ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ద వాట్ ఈస్ గుడ్ అండ్ బ్యాడ్ ఇస్ ద బ్యాడ్ ఈస్ డన్ బై ద గవర్నమెంట్ ఓవర్ హియర్ అండ్ ద గుడ్ ఈస్ వాట్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ ఫీలింగ్ అబౌట్ ఇట్ ఇస్ దట్ దే ఫీల్ దట్ అ రాంగ్ హెస్ బిన్ డన్ టు అక్బరుద్దీన్ ఓవైసీ. లా హెస్ నాట్ బిన్ ఈస్ బీంగ్ యూజ్ సెలెక్టివ్లీ అండ్ ఐ డోంట్ సీ ఎనీథింగ్ పొలిటికలీ బ్యాడ్ హ్యాపెనింగ్ టు అస్ బట్ ద గ్రేట్ బ్యాడ్ విల్ హ్యాపెన్ ఇన్షాల్లా టు ద గవర్నమెంట్ ఓవర్ హియర్.
అంటే ఇప్పుడు మీరు ఆర్ యూ జస్టిఫైయింగ్ యువర్ సమ్ బ్రదర్స్ కామెంట్స్?
నో నో నో, ఐఎమ్ నాట్ జస్టిఫైయింగ్ సార్. ఐఎమ్ సేయింగ్ దట్ దిస్ ఇస్ ఫర్ ద కోర్ట్స్ టు డిసైడ్. మీ అండ్ యూ కెనాట్ సిట్ హియర్ అండ్ డిసైడ్ వెదర్ ఇట్స్ వెదర్ హీ హస్ వయోలేటెడ్ దట్ పర్టికులర్ సెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ఐపీసీ ఫర్ విచ్ ఈస్ బుక్డ్ ఇన్. దట్ ఇస్ ఫర్ ద కోర్ట్స్ టు డిసైడ్.
Ultimately,
courts will decide and Akbaruddin Owaisi will present his defense to the courts and basing on evidence and facts, the courts will take a decision. But as far as our MLA is concerned, certainly we will support him and I am pretty much sure that inshallah he will be exonerated by courts of law.
Itla enduka confidence enduku undi?
Because you know, one is that I believe in the almighty Allah, that Allah will do justice to us, and secondly we know that we have a good case. But I cannot disclose all the things over here. Certainly when the trial starts and everything, you know, we'll come to know about it.
But one thing, whether Allah, God or Christ, whoever may be, everyone is one. All are one.
Oh, yes.
Andar preaching is one. Humanity is one.
Certainly, sir, you know, so in our democracy, freedom of religion is a fundamental right. I can practice and propagate any religion you and me want. So there is no conflict as far as that is concerned.
Yes. బట్ హేట్రెడ్ డెవలప్ చేయకూడదు కదా వేరే వాళ్ళ వేరే రిలీజియన్.
నో వన్ కెన్ ప్రమోట్ హేట్రెడ్ అండ్ దాట్ ఈస్ వై వీ హ్యావ్ ఐపీసీ సెక్షన్స్. ఈవెన్ ఆర్ ఫ్రీడమ్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్ప్రెషన్ ఇస్ అ ఫండమెంటల్ రైట్ బట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ అ కంప్లీట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ అన్ఫెటర్డ్ రైట్.
ఎస్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ,
దట్ ఈస్ ఐ అగ్రీ విత్ యూ. ఎస్,
ఇట్ షుడ్ నాట్ హర్ట్ అదర్స్ ఫీలింగ్స్.
సర్టన్లీ నాట్, సర్టన్లీ నాట్. బట్ మై క్వశ్చన్ ఓవర్ హియర్ ఇస్ దట్ లెట్ మీ గివ్ అన్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఆఫ్ ప్రవీణ్ టుగాడియాస్ ఎలెజ్ హేట్ స్పీచ్. వాట్ యాక్షన్ హెస్ బిన్ టేకన్ సో ఫార్? నో యాక్షన్ హెస్ బిన్ టేకన్. Even if action has been taken, it will be taken, he will not be booked under these severe sections which Akbar is booked. Let me go back in time and tell you, remind you, sir, what Bal Thackeray said. He said that Muslims are like a cancer, they should be treated. He said, Quran, leave Quran or leave Bharat. Then you also remember in 1992, the slogan was coined, Ek Dhakka Aur Do, Babri Masjid Tod Do. We remember very clearly what Narendra Modi said. What Vajpayee said as a prime minister in his Goa musing, that who burned the train. So these are all things which no one wants to look into it.
Exactly.
My request is that in our country there's a huge debate now on gender equality.
Yes,
I am for it.
But why
can't there be communal equality?
Yes, communal.
Why, you know, this selective usage of law is not good for our democracy.
100%.
If I have done a mistake,
yes,
you apply law on me.
Yes.
If X has done it, apply. But this selective usage of law is not good for our healthy democracy.
I do agree. Nenu kuda oppukuntanu. So, meer annattu Togadiya or Modi or Thackeray, evvaru chesina sare, they have to be booked. So, ikkada Indialo inkoka opportunity undi. Suppose if law is not acting anukondi, so a private individual can file a case in the court of law to invoke the law.
Yes.
అది చేయొచ్చుగా మీరు వాళ్ళ మీద కూడా యాక్షన్ తీసుకోవచ్చు.
ఓ, వీ హావ్ డన్ ఇట్ మెనీ టైమ్స్ అండ్ ఇట్ హాస్ నెవర్ బీన్ యూ. సీ, ప్లీజ్ రిమెంబర్ సార్, ఐపీసీ 295, ఇఫ్ ఐ యూస్ 295, గవర్నమెంట్ హ్యాస్ టు గివ్ శాంక్షన్. ఈవెన్ ఇఫ్ ఐ గో టు కోర్ట్ అండ్ ద కోర్ట్ రిఫర్స్ టు
పోలీస్ స్టేషన్,
గవర్నమెంట్ విల్ హావ్ టు గివ్ శాంక్షన్. ద గవర్నమెంట్ నెవర్ గివ్ శాంక్షన్. దే ఆర్ సో మెనీ ఇన్సిడెంట్స్ వేర్ ఇన్ ద గవర్నమెంట్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్ ఐ కెన్ గివ్, గవర్నమెంట్ హాస్ నాట్ గివెన్ శాంక్షన్ ఫర్ ఇట్. దట్ ఈస్ ద డ్రాబ్యాక్. సీ, దేర్ ఈస్ I can be honest, but I can only be honest if I'm intellectually honest.
Yes.
People say he's honest, but I say no, he's not honest because intellectually dishonest. That intellectual dishonesty we are fighting. That communal mindset has to be cleared. Let me give you another example, sir. Aurangabad, I was supposed to go to Aurangabad on 1st of February. I was stopped from going. I was given a 144-1 notice. Same Praveen Tugadia was allowed by Maharashtra government and he gave that hate speech. Now they are still thinking about it. Yes, exactly. Not even dirty. Worse kind of speech you can
say. He replied to Akbaruddin.
Not only replied, but he justified the killings of people in various communal rights.
That is what I am coming to that.
So that is what I am saying.
The people who were killed are only, you remember, they are all Muslims, not Hindus.
I am a member of parliament, taken oath on to uphold the constitution. I am not being allowed to go to Aurangabad, but he is being allowed to go to Nandurbar. So this is what I am saying. This is the difference which people must see.
So discrepancy.
Huge, not only discrimination, but blatant discrimination. Blatant communal behavior.
By and whom?
By the various governments. See, unfortunately, whether you have a secular government or not, our fight is with that communal mindset. That mindset which is prevailing everywhere is hurting the secularism, the ethos of this country. That we'll have to ensure that we should defeat that mindset. That mindset is a huge problem for all of us.
But India lo basic ga, whether it is a Muslim or a Christian or a Hindu, as a common man, there is no hatred between among them. వాళ్ళకేమి తెలియదు, వాళ్ళంతా సింపుల్గా ఉంటారు, దే లివ్ టుగెదర్. బట్ ద మొత్తం ప్రాబ్లం వస్తుంది ఐదర్ సైడ్, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఓన్లీ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ లీడర్స్ కదా.
సార్, ఐ డిసగ్రీ విత్ యూ సార్. ఐ డిసగ్రీ విత్ యూ దట్ ఆఫ్టర్ సచ్ఆర్ కమిటీ హెస్ గివెన్ ఇస్ రిపోర్ట్, ఆఫ్టర్ ద 2001 సెన్సస్ హెస్ కమ్ అవుట్, ఆఫ్టర్ ద రంగనాథ్ మిశ్రా కమిషన్ హెస్ కమ్ అవుట్, ఆఫ్టర్ ద నేషనల్ శాంపుల్ సర్వే 66 రౌండ్ రిపోర్ట్ హెస్ కమ్, అండ్ ఎంపిరికల్ డేటా ఇస్ దేర్ వేర్ ఇన్ ఇట్ క్లియర్లీ షోస్ that out of the minorities, Muslims have been deliberately kept behind socially, educationally, economically. Now, who do you blame for this? I am not a leader of Muslims. I can claim to be. But leader of Muslims are, you know, people who have voted for Muslims. Muslims voted for Chandrababu Naidu or Rajshekhar Reddy or Kiran Kumar Reddy or...
At one point of time, even to Vajpayee.
No, not Vajpayee. I disagree with that. Mulayam Singh Yadav, Lalu Yadav. Now, you tell me, sir, who's responsible? Secondly, in Maharashtra, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, the three bordering states, there are 116 Lok Sabha seats. I am the only single Muslim member of parliament.
South is the only.
Why, sir? Why? Who's responsible for it? You take our Andhra Pradesh, 292, our population, minorities, Muslims, 9.92, 2000 census. How many are there in assembly? 42 parliament seats. How many are there? No, these are the questions which Muslims are asking these secular parties that you are taking our votes. But what is happening to us? You are not giving us power. You are not putting us into assemblies and parliaments. Because unless and until political equality is created, economic equality and social equality cannot happen. Unfortunately, that is the hard reality of our democracy.
That's true. You are talking of democracy.
Yes, certainly.
We are in democracy.
Certainly, sir.
But spreading hatred is a different issue.
No, sir. Sir, so I am sorry. You have formed an opinion already about Akbar.
No, not Akbar. No. See, I equally condemn Togadia. I equally. And if necessary, more also. Because in the Indian system, whatever it is, the majority people, they have to be little patient. Even that is the culture that was taught to us.
Yes.
Even at home also.
Yes.
If suppose among our children, if somebody is weak, the others will support him, right? So that is our culture. So andukani nenu anedi entante hatred ki hatred samadhanam kaagoddu kada anedi.
So certainly, sir, see, two wrongs don't make a right.
Yes.
One cannot promote hatred because that will weaken our country. That will weaken our foundations. But my struggle is for equality. That cannot be equated with hatred.
Yes.
That cannot be equated. It's a political party. It's a political struggle. I have said many times, I like to reiterate again in your esteemed program that we are not against any religion.
Okay.
We are not against Hindus. Our fight is against the Hindutva and communal people. Our fight is for communal equality, for political equal representation, for economic rights. This is our political struggle within the four walls and the parameters of our constitution. And we'll continue to do that. And it is never like that. Now, all this hatred which is going on, you know, there has to be debate in the country. There must be a debate in this country and there must be an end to such.
No, either side, evaraina oka opportunity iste, the other party will take advantage. So, Togadia, suppose he makes some dirty statement ankonde. The other side, they take advantage. Like that Akbaruddin statement, the others will take advantage. they create emotions and commotions, whatever it is.
I don't think so, sir, that doing such thing will fetch you electoral victory, because people are very shrewd, people are very understanding, people will not fall in this trap. What will ensure my political victory or electoral victory is my work on the ground, my organization, my program, how accessible I am, what kind of image I have. Emotional issues can create sensation for a while, but that will not lead to electoral victory. That will not lead to electoral victory. I understand that. And that is why the success of MIM has never been this emotional upsurge.
Okay.
The success of MIM has been always fighting for the people, being accessible to them, and that is what has brought us electoral victory so far. We will continue to do that same.
యాక్చువల్గా మీ ఇద్దరు బ్రదర్స్ అంటే మీరు కానీ మీ తమ్ముడు అక్బరుద్దీన్ చాలామందికి రెస్పెక్ట్ ఉంది. అంటే నేను ముస్లిమ్స్ గురించి కూడా కాదు, హిందూస్లో అంటే పీపుల్ లైక్ అస్ యూస్ టు అడ్మైర్. అండ్ ఒకటి
ఓన్లీ యూస్ టు ఆర్ నాట్ నాట్ నౌ
నో 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 ఆల్వేస్ ఆల్వేస్ జస్ట్ నార్మల్ యూసేజ్ కదా. వీ రెస్పెక్ట్ వీ అడ్మైర్. వై రీజన్ ఈజ్ వెల్ ఎడ్యుకేటెడ్, మీరు బ్యూటిఫుల్గా మాట్లాడతారు. అక్బరుద్దీన్ లాస్ట్ టైం అసెంబ్లీలో మాట్లాడిన స్పీచ్కి చాలామంది ఫిదా అయ్యారు, చాలామంది అప్రిషియేట్ చేశారు. చేసిన తర్వాత ఈ నిర్మల స్పీచ్ తర్వాత అదేంటి అంత బాగా మాట్లాడే అక్బరుద్దీన్ అలా ఎందుకు మాట్లాడాడు? వై
సార్ లెట్ మీ జస్ట్ టచ్ దట్ స్పీచ్ ఫర్ అ వైల్. ఐ డోంట్ మైండ్ బికాస్ నౌ యూ బ్రాట్ ఇట్ ఇన్. నౌ ఇఫ్ దేర్ ఇస్ అ సెంటెన్స్, ఇఫ్ యూ డోంట్ వర్షిప్ గాడ్ యూ ఆర్ అ ఫూల్.
ఎస్.
నౌ ఇఫ్ యూ టేక్ అవుట్ ఇఫ్ యూ డోంట్ వర్షిప్ and you only say God, you are a fool, then you'll see you're telling God a fool.
If you divide the sentence.
Exactly, that is what I'm saying. And in that, in whatever CD the police has sees now, I have seen that CD, in that he has said, this is my country. I love this country. I was born here. I will go inside this soil. He said, we are not against any temples. We want reconstruction of Babri Masjid. He has condemned Kasab. But out of context sentences, and you project it as this is what he said, that is the difficulty.
Okay.
But anyway, sir, now I don't want to go more deeper into it. Let the courts decide, and Akbar will present his defense in the courts of law basing on the evidence which is there.
That's true. Ante nene endante well educated kada, unlike your father also, you meekunna image veru mee iddarki kuda, mee iddaru kuda chaala baa maatladtaru, manchi language kada subject maatladtaru.
Yes,
yes. Ebavallu endante subject maatladatam anedi chaala takku mandi maatladtaru off late.
Yes, sir.
సో ఇప్పుడు దాకా మీరు మాట్లాడింది కూడా చాలా క్లియర్గా మాట్లాడారు.
ఎస్.
సో అట్లా ఉన్నప్పుడు ఏంటంటే ఇమేజ్ నెక్స్ట్ ఇప్పుడు ఇండియన్ పొలిటికల్ సిస్టంలో డే ఆఫ్టర్ డే యూత్ ఇంపార్టెన్స్ పెరుగుతుంది. సో వాళ్ళు ఏంటంటే వాళ్ళని అటాక్ చేసుకోవడానికి మీరు ఈ క్యారెక్టర్ అయితే బాగుంటుంది అనుకుంటున్నారా, సోబర్ క్యారెక్టర్ అయితే బాగుంటుంది అనుకుని ఆలోచన చేస్తున్నారు?
నో నో సార్. సార్ యాజ్ యూ రైట్లీ సెడ్, ఈవెన్ అవర్ అప్బ్రింగింగ్ బై అవర్ లేట్ ఫాదర్ అండ్ బై అవర్ పేరెంట్స్ వాజ్ న్యూ దట్ దిస్ ఇస్ వాట్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు డూ. And whatever goodness we have is because of Allah and because of my parents. Now, this image which you are talking about, sir, this whole publicity of Akbar's speech, we didn't ask for it. Even in Amul ad, Akbar is there. I didn't ask for it. This whole blowing it out of proportions, I didn't ask for it. Media lynched and mobbed Akbar in not your studio, but every other studio discussion happened. I am not to be blamed for it. We don't want this image at all. You know, you are rightly that we very boldly, very clearly, we have raised public issues in assembly and in parliament. We'll continue to do that. We'll continue to do that. There is no stopping to it. What we are saying is that I want the people who are watching your program to please understand one thing, that Akbaruddin's speech was given first in Nizamabad on 8th of December. Case was registered after 23 days.
Yes.
8th Nizamabad, 23rd Nirmal. If Nizamabad was objectionable, why did they give permission for Nirmal? And if a Nirmal anti-national statement was given, why did he take this government 11 days to realize that he has given something anti-national statement? Please look into it. Please remember this and then form your opinion. Because Nizamabad and Nirmal, not even 70 kilometers are there. So these are two things I want the people of your channel, your show, to before forming an opinion, please look into these two points. And then form your opinion.
The sad part is, law is not acting on its own. That is the problem.
Where is it happening?
Yeah, it's not acting on its own.
You know,
unless somebody motivates, somebody invokes.
No, sir.
So, even in Akbaruddin case also, I strongly believe that it is because of the chief ministers. Your animosity with the chief minister. Anukuntunna, avuna?
Sir, that is what is happening. See, because but for our withdrawal of support, would Akbar would be in prison for 1 month? I don't know. But for our withdrawal of support, whether I would have gone to Sangareddy jail, you know, I leave it to the
people.
No, sir, I leave it to the people. People are more clever, people are more shrewder, because when they go and exercise their oath for me, it clearly shows that they have more wisdom than me. They understand more me. And I leave it to the people. I leave it to the people because end of the day, no matter what the government does or I do, the people are the masters in democracy. If they feel I'm right, they will elect me. If I'm wrong, they'll make me say, no, please take rest. I'm pretty much sure that come 2014, my strength, which was there, which will be there, it might increase, inshallah. We are trying for it. But I cannot say about the ruling party now.
Okay.
Because the message that has gone, wrong message has gone. I have been telling the government and some people, you have some common friends. See, you keep this fight within the four walls of our state. A shrewd politician will keep this fight within Andhra Pradesh. But now, it has blown out of Andhra Pradesh.
Yeah.
It has gone to Maharashtra, it has gone to Karnataka. Who will be the beneficiary? Who will lose? They must understand. And what is the message you have sent? They must understand.
When it comes to the national elections, what is the option to Muslims? Congress, BJP, two. So, you cannot blame Congress party as a religious party, fundamental party.
Yes, sir.
It is certainly, I do believe that it is a secular party.
You believe? Yes.
Yeah. Okay. You don't believe?
No, no. Well, no. You see, I cannot question your belief. You are a senior man. I have been seeing you from last time.
I am asking.
No, no. My question is that I have been reiterating this point that we will never do such thing which will bring back NDA in power. Now, when I say this, even Chandrababu Naidu is with me. Even Jagan Mohan Reddy is with me. Even Congress party is there with me. That we agree on this point that NDA should not come back in power. Secondly, when I say we do not want Modi as a prime minister, even TDP does not want him. Jagan Mohan Reddy doesn't want him. Congress does not want him. And many secular parties. Now, what is that? Your automatic question, now what is then what you want? Then that numbers will decide. As of now, sir, I cannot say what will happen. I don't know the knowledge of unseen. But definitely I can tell you that as a political party, we'll try our utmost best to ensure that NDA does not come back in power. We have to try our utmost best to give a message to the people of India.
No, what I mean to say is, Congress enemies goda. Congress is not a secular party and criticize cheyaleru. Except that Babri episode when P.V. Narasimha Rao was Prime Minister, adi pakkana pedithe, Congress religious party and gaani, or they encourage the fundamentalism and gaani, anlaru kada.
Sir, one cannot deny the role of P.V. Narasimha Rao in the demolition of Babri Masjid. But for him, the Babri Masjid would not have been demolished. If Babri Masjid would not have been demolished, then certain incidents would not have taken place in India, whether it's Mumbai blast or riots and everything. Now, having said that, I can say that I respect the present Congress president a lot. I have been part of UPA for 8 years. She has given me immense respect. I'll continue to respect her. But what will be the result of 2014? I don't know. It looks very shady.
Yeah,
it looks very difficult. You know, no one is able to get its political arithmetic right.
Exactly.
But we can say with certainty that we don't want NDA. We don't want Modi to become the prime minister, whoever it is from NDA. We'll have to strive for it. We'll have to work for it. What political calculations will happen afterwards, then the people of India will decide. Let there be a debate. Now, it is good that whether India will go towards communalism or secularism, that people of India will certainly decide. I am sure that majority of Indians will adopt secularism.
Miku Kiranto Yendika Chief Minister to Tagada Vachindi.
Sir, let me share a joke with you. Whole Andhra politics is based on Hyderabad Public School.
Yes, exactly. He is also product of Hyderabad Public School.
Kiran Kumar Reddy, Hyderabad Public School.
Yes.
Bapi Raju, TDD Chair, Hyderabad Public School.
Public School.
DGP, Hyderabad Public
yes.
School. Jagan Mohan Reddy, Hyderabad Public School. Asaduddin Akbar, Hyderabad Public School.
Oh.
Vivek,
yes.
Telangana, Padyapal AP, Hyderabad Public School. So, it is fight amongst all HPO's old students.
Earlier, when childhood and student days, you fight with him?
No, sir. He is much senior to me.
Yeah, he is senior.
He is about
8 years or so.
Yeah. His two younger brothers were with me in Nizam College. We are classmates, his two younger brothers, very good friends. But now, with I don't know whether they consider me as a friend or not, but definitely I was there with them in Nizam College, his younger brothers.
And what made you?
Sir,
differences.
Sir, political differences have happened because in last 2 years, there were many communal incidents which took place. We had always gone and told him, sir, this is happening, please take care, this is not good. Communal riot took place in Adhuni, in Sangareddy. In Sangareddy, when a Muslim delegation went and met the Honorable Chief Minister and told him that there is, people are saying that you please probe the local MLA's involvement. He said, no, he's not involved, but evidence is there. Then last year in Bakri, sir, last year Bakri, 12 stabbing incidents took place, one Muslim was murdered. So these are things which you said, this is not good, this cannot happen in a government wherein we are supporting you. And we have been supporting the Congress party from
1998.
Certainly, certainly this was brought to her notice, not me, but this was brought to her notice by various people. And it's not that the Congress central leaders don't know about it. They know about it. They don't know about it. But end of the day, if who's the captain? The captain of the team is the chief minister. So he has to respond to it. And when the no confidence motion took place, we supported them. Sir, 14 years is a long time. You know,
yes.
They don't understand that Chandrababu Naidu was a formidable chief minister. He supported BJP. We didn't support him.
Yes.
Because of that point only. But he was a formidable chief minister. To replace him, to bring him down from power, was a great Herculean effort.
Yes.
Which Congress party led by Rajshekhar Reddy, Namula Narasimhaya and myself, we played a major role in that. CPM, MIM, and Congress party. It was not easy because Chandrababu Naidu was a very formidable opponent. And they don't realize that. 14 years and we never ran after power. We were never pre-poll ally. We won on our strength. I don't have any other, see, I'm a third generation politician. I don't know, my life is politics. I'll die in politics. I don't know what kind of ally do they want, and it's up to them to realize. So because of all these things, and then the Charminar Mandir issue which came up, we went to court, we got a court order, we didn't come out in streets and protested. The court said maintain status quo. The government said, no, this is not a status quo. We will reinterpret in the wrong way. Hindu newspaper has shown a photograph. Outlook magazine has written an article on it. This clearly shows that who's wrong, who's right. So, basing on this, we were forced to withdraw our support to the government over
here. Meeru Jagan Reddy close ayyarani uddeshinte unna.
No, I'm close to you, sir. I'm close to you.
But I'm not a politician.
No, you're not a politician, but I'm close to you. See, if friendship is there, contacts will be there, irrespective of which party you belong to. But will that lead to a political decision making in favor of a friend? No. Decision will be made according to what suits me, what suits you. You know, I cannot make a decision because X is my friend. Jagan Mohan Reddy is a friend, will remain a friend. But political decision to go with him or not to go with him, that what will be there on the ground, how will it help me, whether I should go and support TDP, whether I should support TRS or any secular party, or even Arvind Kejriwal is also there. So these are all things which will happen when
options are open.
And of course, options are open, and when elections are announced, when the elections are there, of course we'll decide, and I'm going to keenly follow your ABN survey and make my decision. Because if your survey comes out, we'll follow that survey.
No. As far as my information is concerned, you're chala clean. You never took money from anybody. Corruption.
Sir, that is true, and this is what we have learned from our father, that whatever he can do, we do it. But allegations are made, and allegations are not substantiated. But in political life, everyone makes an allegation. I cannot stop anyone, sir.
No, that is a different story. Okay, allegations.
We try our level best to ensure that we don't fall in this dirt. We try our level best.
Meer clean image to unnapudu anni corrupt allegations face chestunna Jagan Mohan Reddy etla friendship cheddam anukunnaru political ga?
Sir, again, I am telling you, that courts of law will decide. I cannot answer for
but
his.
But on the face of it, as a politician, will you agree or not?
For me, what the Indian law says, that he is, any person accused, whether me or X or Y, Z, he is innocent until proven guilty. He is facing the courts. He is facing the cases. The courts will decide. But if I call you my friend, you might face some hard times in your life. Does that mean that I should avoid you? No, I will not avoid you. Your matter with courts is between you and the courts. But my friendship with you will continue. I'll certainly call on. I spoke to other leader also, whether it's TDP. We know we maintain contacts. We go to their marriages. If they are ill, they come and meet me. When Akbar was injured by attack, there are many leaders from political parties. Mr. Naidu came, not once, twice he came. And 3-4 times he spoke to me on phone inquiring about Akbar's health. Even now also he called and asked me, how's Akbar? So see, these are human contacts cannot be finished because of our political differences.
Human contacts are different and political contacts are different.
Certainly, sir. Certainly, you're right. You're right. Absolutely. I agree with you. I agree with you.
Suppose if you are convinced, leave alone this act and court. If you are convinced that I am guilty or I am a murderer or whatever it is, if I committed a theft, ankonde dongatanam chesam meer natho maavulu normal relations maintain cheyaleru kada.
No sir, but I still have to abide by the legal saying he is innocent until proven guilty. If the courts of law will say he is guilty, then certainly I'll say, okay, this man is guilty, I should avoid him now. But till that time, I have to give him benefit of doubt. I cannot do it. The law is there.
If that is the case, the same formula applies to Narendra Modi also. He is not found guilty by any court of this country.
Absolutely right. But morally and ethically, he is responsible because the chief minister he is. Jagan Mohan Reddy, if he is a chief
minister. Son
of the chief minister, right. But under Mr. Narendra Modi's rule, 3,000 people were killed. Under Narendra Modi's rule, Ishrat Jahan was falsely encountered. Under Narendra Modi's rule, this Kodnani lady was sentenced to for rigorous 15 years imprisonment. He is responsible for that. So there is a huge difference between Narendra Modi's example and Jagan Modi's example. And Ishrat Jahan encounter, then our Ehsan Jafri's case. So Mr. Modi is responsible because under his leadership.
He was in power.
He is in power under his leadership. And courts of law have convicted his minister.
Yeah.
His ministers have been convicted.
Yes.
Now over here, we have to wait and see. In this case, which examples you are giving, you have to wait and see what courts of law will do.
No, even when Chandrababu was chief minister, Rajshekhar Reddy, because of Rajshekhar Reddy, communal tension, which is a long period, 18 days, there was a curfew.
Yes, I know. I was studying in London at that time, but I know in 1990 that this thing has happened. But I am yet to read that inquiry report I have read, which after the riots. But in that inquiry report, there is no such thing is there. There is no such thing which is there.
But a chief minister,
No, after that, our communal riots, when the inquiry was formed, that the committee was formed, in that report I have read, I don't remember the name of the judge or retired judge, no such thing was mentioned about it.
Okay.
But anyway, whatever it is, sir, if people will pay for it, if you are wrong, the law will ensure that you pay for it and the people will.
Our God.
God, certainly, sir.
God is there.
Oh, yes.
If you can escape from the law,
you cannot escape from God, sir. I mean, He is the one who created the world. He is the one who created you and me. He knows what is right and wrong more than all of us.
And
of course, the divine justice will happen.
So, truly follow the Radhi. Miru.
Pardon, sir?
Follow the Radhi.
Yeah.
So, Miru, two seats in 7 seats, it is only Congress party help, and the Chief Minister said.
Unfortunately, his political memory is wrong. See, 62, we were only one. Then afterwards, increased 2. Then 3.
4.
Then 5.
Yes.
Then we came down to only one, me,
yes.
in 94. Then we came down to 4.
Yes.
Increased to 4. Then we won a by-election against Nagendra, against Rajshekhar Reddy.
Yeah.
5. Now 7. Where we are to, and maybe he does not, why isn't he not saying that for Mr. Shushankar's election, you remember, sir, Shushankar by-election, Secunderabad, in Madam late Indira Gandhi had come to Darussalam. She shared a dais with my father, and we supported late Indira Gandhi in Medak election.
In Medak.
And then in this trust vote, when the chief minister requested us to support him, we supported him. So he's conveniently forgetting. And he's conveniently forgetting that we are not a pre-poll alike. We are not a pre-poll alike.
Yes.
And I think so. You should call and ask some of these our friends who are there in city MLAs or ministers and ask them the same thing. Who benefited from Manjali's support or loss? So this is wrong. His political arithmetic is wrong.
మీరు స్ప్రెడ్ అవ్వాలనుకుంటున్నారు కదా అంటే స్ట్రెంగ్త్ గెయిన్ చేయాలనుకుంటున్నారు కదా ఎలక్షన్ ఆఫ్టర్ ఎలక్షన్
సార్ ఎవ్రీ పొలిటికల్ పార్టీ వి వాంట్ టు స్ప్రెడ్
yes exactly
టు స్ప్రెడ్ వి వాంట్ టు ఇంక్రీస్ దేర్ స్ట్రెంగ్త్ దేర్ ఇస్ నథింగ్ రాంగ్ ఇన్ దట్ ఐ హావ్ బీన్ డూయింగ్ దట్ నాట్ ఓన్లీ ఇన్ ఆంధ్రప్రదేశ్ బట్ ఆల్సో ఇన్ మహారాష్ట్ర ఇన్ నాందేడ్ వి కంటెస్టెడ్ వి గాట్ 11 కార్పొరేటర్స్ అదర్ ఏరియాస్ వి కంటెస్టెడ్ వి లాస్ట్ కర్ణాటక ఇన్ బిదర్ వి ఆర్ ఎక్స్పాండింగ్ ఇన్ హుమ్నాబాద్ ఇన్ రాయచూర్ సో of course, as a political party, I want to expand. But end of the day, it is the people will decide whether I am relevant or not.
Kani, inta spread jayasi, meer party ni strengthen jayalan kunna atharavadha koda. ఏపీలోనే మీరు మెయిన్ లాంగ్వేజ్ తెలుగు ఎందుకు మాట్లాడలేకపోతున్నారు?
సర్టన్లీ సార్, దిస్ ఇస్ ఐ విలింగ్ టు అక్సెప్ట్ దట్ దిస్ ఇస్ అ హ్యూజ్ డ్రాబ్యాక్ ఫర్ మీ అండ్ ఐఎమ్ అష్యూరింగ్ యూ దట్ ఇన్షాల్లా విద్ ఇన్ అ ఇయర్ ఐ విల్ లర్న్ దిస్ లాంగ్వేజ్ and if I want to master it, I want to communicate, because of me not able to speak in this language,
yes,
my message is not able to send. People understand me the wrong way, people form a wrong conclusions. So language I have to learn, I think so, and I'll try my level best, take out some time.
There is a gap vachestundi, meer eppudu only urdu maatadatappudu
absolutely right
other telugu speaking
certainly
people.
Sir, you are absolutely, I agree with you totally. I have to learn this language, I must be able to communicate my views with the larger masses.
Yes.
Which I'm not able to do. I'm only been limited. When people will know what I stand for, what is my actual message, I'm certainly all this miscommunication will completely finish. I mean, this is a wrong impressions and wrong message will completely go.
Oh, ఎవరన్నా ట్విట్టర్ పెట్టుకుంటారా?
Certainly, I contacted one Mr. Sharma. He is willing to come and teach me. But because of my preoccupation with my political work and my laziness, you know, I have to overcome. I have to really tell myself, no, I have to learn this language.
Normally, ఎప్పుడు లేస్తారు మీరు మార్నింగ్?
No, morning I get up at 4:45, sir. Come what may, I get up early in the morning, and that is my routine, has been routine. I get up at 4:45 and then, but I sleep by 12:30. I cannot do much. But 3 days in Sangareddy prison, after 15-16 years, I slept at 9:30. I was thanking the government.
Thanks to government.
Thanks to government.
Jail lo nidra pattinda Sangareddy prison lo?
Yeah, this is the sixth time I have been. I was guest of Chandrababu Naidu when he was chief minister,
yeah.
four or five times.
Yes.
So now Kiran Kumar Reddy has sent me. So anyway, these are political, in political life, these are ups and downs will happen. One cannot run away from this thing. But this will make you more stronger, this will make you think more clearer. So this is part of political life.
Endukante meeru spread strengthen kavalanukunnappudu other community people kuda meeku support cheyalika.
Yes, certainly
cheyalante meeru vaalla toti communication develop cheskovalsinde, inevitable.
Yes, certainly.
Only Muslims valla
no
develop kaleru party.
Yes, certainly you see, because my real intention is that in Andhra Pradesh Muslims, Dalits have to come together along with OBCs. I would very much like the political atmosphere of UP and Bihar to be replicated in Andhra Pradesh, because whether it's Dalits or OBCs, our socio backwardness, educational backwardness are equal. And I feel that the reason for that backwardness is only because of not having political power. Once we have political power, certainly development will happen. This is the reality of our parliamentary democracy. You have political power, you get justice. You don't have political power, then you don't get justice.
Okay, ikkada oka issue adugutanu nenu. UP lo mayawati chief minister ga chesindi.
Yes sir.
But akkada em develop avaledu kada dalits.
Dalits have developed, sir. Dalits have respect. Dalits have let me give you one example. If any incident happens on Dalit, before even that victim goes, the police registers a complaint. That sort of respect Mayawati has created for Dalits, that sort of fear she has created among the administration, that when it comes to her core base, you cannot mess around with it. That is what Mayawati has done. I have been to UP, sir. I have been and visited. We can debate about development, backwardness. Yes, I agree with you. But as far as Dalits are concerned, as far as their upliftment is concerned, we have to give credit to Mayawati. We have to look at the way the Dalits are getting elected. And she has transferred her Dalit vote to Muslims also, which no one is able to do. We Muslims are voting for secular parties, but the secular parties are not able to transfer their votes.
Yes.
Take the example of Mehboob Nagar.
Yes.
Take the example of Shabir Saab, twice
yes.
he lost.
Yes.
Yusuf Ali, Fariduddin in Andhra Pradesh. That Mayawati is able to do, which no one is able to do. That is the greatness of BSP over there.
But old city ko vachinappudu, when it comes to Hyderabad, హైదరాబాద్ ఎందుకు డెవలప్ కావట్లేదు? బికాస్ ఆల్మోస్ట్ ఫర్ ద పాస్ట్ 5 డికేడ్స్ అది మజ్లిస్ కంట్రోల్లో ఉంది కదా. ఇట్ ఇస్ ద బాస్టన్ ఫర్ మజ్లిస్ పార్టీ.
నో, ఇట్ ఈస్ రాంగ్ సార్. ఇట్ ఈస్ రాంగ్ టు సే దట్ దిర్ ఇస్ నో డెవలప్మెంట్. దెర్ ఇస్ సర్టన్లీ డెవలప్మెంట్. ఐ కెన్ సిట్ డౌన్ అండ్ డిబేట్ విత్ ఎనీవన్ దట్ వీ హ్యావ్ నాట్ డెవలప్డ్. టేక్ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్, వెన్ రాజశేఖర్ రెడ్డి చీఫ్ మినిస్టర్, హీ అనౌన్స్డ్ అ ప్యాకేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఓసిటీ డెవలప్మెంట్. అండర్ దాట్ సార్, నియర్లీ 500 or 600 crores వర్త్ ఆఫ్ న్యూ డ్రైనేజ్ లైన్స్, సూరేజ్ లైన్స్ హెవ్ బీన్ లేడ్. బట్ దిస్ గవర్నమెంట్ హెస్ స్టాప్డ్ That funding.
Okay.
Another 2 constituencies of Karwan and Nampally has to be added. They have stopped doing that. They are not giving money to the contractors. So development is there. Yes, more needs to be done. I agree with you. Yes, we need to do more. We need to have more schools. I agree with you. We need to have more primary health dispensaries. I agree with you. But you cannot say that I have not worked for it. I have certainly worked for it. I have used my MP fund. Our MLAs have used their fund. Our corporators have used their funds. We are representing the government. Now, let me give one example, sir. In May 2011, Chief Minister came and inaugurated an elevated parking lot, first of its kind in nation. That work is still to start it. Who can you blame me for that? Charmiar Unani Hospital, Chief Minister came inaugurated for another block. How can you blame me for that? It is for the government to do it. Charmiar pedestrianization, it is state government work. You don't want to do it. So these are the responsibility also lies with the administration. But as far as our efforts are concerned, you cannot doubt our efforts. You can say no more needs to be done. I agree with you. But I cannot take this claim that no, you have not done anything. That is wrong, sir.
I am talking about the economic development of the whole city people. That there is no change.
No, sir.
There
was no Maruti showroom. There was no Maruti showroom, Maruti showroom is there. Is that an indicator of economic development or not?
I don't agree.
No, it shows no.
We have world class brand
Maruti.
But sections are suffering.
You cannot equate Maruti with BMW.
Yeah.
Maruti is Maruti.
But yes.
Maruti showroom is there. It is there. You have lot of shops over there. Economic activity is happening. We have to create more conducive atmosphere for the overall economic development of whole city. Yes, that will happen. That unless until the government does not agree, cooperate with you, you cannot do it. And then other areas of economic activity is lot of, new road widening has taken place. New shops have come. We are trying our best, sir. I can agree with you that you should do more. I am certainly agreeing with you. But what you should
that
say,
is a continuous process, doing more.
Of course,
more and
of
more.
Course, it's a continuous process. But one cannot make this wrong allegation that I have not done anything. That is a wrong allegation to make.
Okay, I don't know whether I can ask this or not.
No, you please.
Okay,
feel free.
So the main reason, nenu akkada old city lo nenu reporter ga unnappudu akkada curfew pettinappudu visit chesinappudu chusina situation prakaram entante main reason for poverty ki entante the growth of children. Too many children, chinna family untundi, no proper income, but 10-15 pillalu evvaru kuda chadukoleru adi alanti paristhithi nunchi meer iddaru kuda brothers well educated meer London lo jari vacharu koncham progress ga velladaniki endu prayatnam cheyunnam cheppandi Asaduddin garu
this point which you have raised, if you look at 2001 census, the census says that there has been a lesser growth of Muslim population as compared to the 81 census, the 91 census. So definitely the Muslim population is not increasing, it's coming down. But in terms of, if you compare other religion, yes, it is still higher. Secondly, economic development has to take place. And for that, we are trying our utmost best. You have given example of how people live in one small house and they're cramped. That is why we had gone to this government and told them that in Chandrababu assembly constituency, there is 100 acres of government land. Nowhere in India, in any metropolitan city, any city has 100 acres of land. We showed this to government, this is 100 acres. Akbar made a promise to the people of his constituency and whole city that we will construct housing over here with the government. We had given a representation showing that 10,000 houses can be constructed for all the people, not only Muslims, but Dalits and
whoever may be.
Nothing is happening. Can you believe it, sir? A court stay is still there. In 2 years, for last 3 years now, that court stay is not vacated. 100 acres of land in heart of the city, not in RR district, in Hyderabad. What can we do if the government is not rising up to the occasion?
That is one part.
I am saying that to a certain extent, this problem can be taken care of.
Agreed.
If you provide housing to the poor people, of course, you will be decreasing their pain. And they are suffering. Government is not willing to do that. What I am doing is, sir, I am running two hospitals.
I am asking is, I don't know whether religion permits or not. Earlier, even in our families also, our forefathers used to have half a dozen, 8 to 10 children. But after that, after experiencing the problems, because the whatever little there.
Sir, can I give a counter argument to what you are saying?
Yeah.
The counter argument is, why can't you follow China model?
Yes.
Population has become an asset, not a liability.
But now they have put conditions.
No, sir. Now there's
rigidly they are following. No, if anybody produces more than two children,
no, sir, now,
they will be denied of all the government.
No, sir. I'll tell you. Please read the latest article in Foreign Affairs or in foreign some magazine, intellectual. I mean, this think tank is there. They are say China is debating now that because of their one child norm, there's a huge sex ratio discrepancy between male and female. And also they are saying that they, to continue with their progress and their economic and dominance in the world, they have to have good population. My only question is, why can't you follow a Chinese model of making this population an asset towards not a liability? You have more skill development centers, you have more schools. This in itself will create an environment of economic prosperity. This will broaden people's thinking horizon. Let us use it as an asset. Convert it into asset. We are not doing that.
Already it is a overcrowded country. India, 120 crores.
Yes, this is an asset to us. This is an asset to us. If
you look at it properly.
If we use this manpower, believe me, India can grow way much ahead. But provided that you focus on skill development, you focus on schools, and healthcare center. These are three important things which any government should do. But unfortunately, our spending in health sector, in education, is not even 3% of our GDP. I am of the view that let us follow the Chinese model, wherein they have used their huge population to their advantage. That we should do.
No, I am talking about not as a country, as
an
individual. See, unless economic growth, economic strength, you attain, మీకు వస్తే తప్పితే పొలిటికల్ పవర్ రాదు. ఎకనామిక్ పవర్ అండ్ పొలిటికల్ పవర్ విల్ గో టుగెదర్ మోర్ ఆర్ లెస్.
సార్, ఐ బెగ్ టు డిఫర్ విత్ యూ. ఐ డోంట్ సీ దిస్ గ్రోత్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ ఫ్యామిలీ హ్యావింగ్ 5-6 మెంబర్ యాజ్ అ స్టాపింగ్ ఫర్ అవర్ ప్రోగ్రెస్. ఐ ఫీల్ దట్ విల్ బీ అ స్టెప్పింగ్ స్టోన్ ఫర్ ప్రోగ్రెస్. ప్రొవైడెడ్ యూ క్రియేట్ స్కిల్ డెవలప్మెంట్, యూ క్రియేట్ స్కూల్స్. దిస్ ఇస్ ద బేసిక్ నెసెసిటీ విచ్ ఎనీ గవర్నమెంట్ షుడ్ డూ.
ఓకే. So let us agree to disagree.
I disagree with you. Yes.
So Miku, Nomal Narasimha was the best friend and he was in opposition.
Good colleague, yes.
Okay, next to your seat. But old city lo ivala CPM is a bitter enemy.
No.
Meek against ga vallu.
No, I don't want
to use targeted MIM.
I don't want to use the word enemy. Maybe your political opponents.
Okay, political
enemy is a very strong word.
Ante enemy endukanna ante strong word ante there were fights between the two groups also. So
Madhu was skirmishes, skirmishes.
Madhu was beaten.
No,
and vice versa.
I have the highest respect for Mr. Raghavlu. You know, I interact with him. But as far as sir, if you look at the assembly elections, parliament elections and municipal elections, please form your opinion. I leave it to you and the people. The people have given their opinion and their verdict. So I don't feel that
enduku gap enduku vachindi asala endukante CPM is a champion for secularism, right?
Yes.
But why they are concentrating in old city anedi, it's a big question.
I cannot.
What they want ante there is no development, economic development and overall development in old city among the old city people. Andukani memu, we are taking up the responsibility and we want to throw away MIM anedi.
They are welcome. They are welcome to make their claims and contentions. They are welcome to work. In a democracy, I cannot stop anyone from expanding their party. I cannot stop them from making claims. Whether they are wrong or right, that people will decide. I welcome them. They can work. I have no problem.
you are confident. That is why you are welcoming.
No, certainly, I'm confident.
They can't do anything.
No, certainly, I'm confident, sir. Certainly, I'm confident. So people will decide. Of course, you know, they can claim whatever they want. But end of the day, what I do or people will like it or not. But what they are saying, people have given them a verdict in 2009. Telugu Desam, yeah, and TRS and CPM,
Mahakutumi
was there.
Yes.
And people have given their verdict. So I'm pretty much sure. See, so long as I am accessible to public, number one. Secondly, I am willing to stand up for them. I am reflecting their problems. And last point, I am trying my level best. These are the four things which have always helped us. We'll continue to do that. And then people will decide.
బట్ మీ ఫాదర్ కూడా ఎంబీటీ అప్సర్జన్ ఆపలేకపోయారు. మీరు వచ్చిన తర్వాత మజ్లిస్ పార్టీని టేక్ ఓవర్ చేసిన తర్వాత మీ లీడర్షిప్లో ఎంబీటీని కంట్రోల్ చేసి పరిచారు. There is no opponent in the old city for
you. No, sir. Actually, you see, like, you cannot deny the role of NTR Rao in TDP's dominance or relevance in other politics.
Yes.
The same, we can never forget the great sacrifices made by our late leader.
Of course, sir.
But for him, we will not be here. But for him, I will not be here sitting in front of you. So, he will continue to guide in us because of the hard struggle which he has done. In those days, going on a motorcycle, going on in that jeep.
I have seen him going on motorcycle.
So, that hard struggle and that hard work, the sincerity, I even lack that, sir.
Mm.
That when I see and I compare myself with him, with his
but
hard
you're
work.
But you are a great schemer.
No. Not schemer, sir. I am an honest man.
No, a schemer means that is not a scamster.
No. Thank you.
Political.
No, sir. As far as I am concerned, you know, his life is a guiding force for me. The way he has worked hard sincerely, day in, day out. I have seen him to work continuously for 3-4 days without sleep. So, that is itself is a great guiding way for us. And he'll continue to be our great leader. Sir. People like me will come and go, but there will be no replacement for Sultan Salahuddin Owaisi.
Okay.
There will be no replacement.
And then, if you have opponent, MBT has become week and week. Year after year.
Sir, I am thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to the people who elected me. I am very thankful to them. That because of them, we are getting elected. Because of them, our opponents are losing ground day by day. It is all mercy of Allah that
he is. All sudden, Akbaruddin meeda endukanta attack jarigindi almost he was luckily saved.
Oh yes. God
endukanta anta hatred gaani university enduku vachindi opponent group lo.
I really don't know, sir. This has never happened. This has never happened to us because in our whole 52 years of our political life, we have never done anything personally against XYZ.
Okay.
The people who attacked him, the main conspirator was an election agent for Telugu Desam party against me.
Mm.
It was a political fight. And then secondly, that 100 acres of land which is there, it's a government land. When during election campaign, we have said that this is a government land.
Okay.
Government records have proven it. I don't know. This is a well-hatched conspiracy on their behalf because they could not defeat us politically.
Mm.
So, they wanted to annihilate us personally.
Mm.
And that is why they have hatched this conspiracy to kill Akbaruddin Owaisi.
Mm.
But God is great. You see, when God has created the world, He has given me a life. He has given a new life to Akbaruddin Owaisi.
Mm.
And these people have been badly exposed. And I am very surprised that even now they continue to be in TDP.
Who? Pile 1?
These people in TDP. Mm. They continue to be in TDP.
I don't know. Pile 1 is in TDP
yes,
now?
Yes, in TDP. He was an election agent of TDP.
The main accused, na?
Yes, one. Main conspirator. Yeah. He is still in TDP.
Mm.
I want the Telugu Desam party to disown these people.
No, did you ask this to Chandrababu Naidu?
Sir, why should I ask? You see, this
no, he you was know, your no, no, best when, friend when, earlier. No,
sir, let me tell you honestly, we are not afraid of them.
Mm.
When someone wants to take us on, we are ready for it. Always, okay. In whatever way they want. They want to do it personally, I am ready for it. They want to be political, I am ready for it. But it is for the political party to whom they represent to take a stand on it.
Mm.
To take a stand on it and say, we don't want these people. But by not disowning them, it is hurting TDP everywhere. It is hurting, I am telling you, it is hurting TDP. Not only that, but also that corporator.
No, you are the Chief Minister of Chandrababu Naidu, you are positive about it. So, you have no option in the future. We have not ruled out.
Yeah.
TDP to alliance.
You are putting words.
No. Options. Jagannmohan Reddy one side, this is one side.
I don't know what people will decide in 2014.
Yeah, that is what I am saying. So, why can't you advise?
Sir, how can I advise a person who has been chief minister for 9 years? He has seen.
You should understand that.
He has met Bill Gates and Bill Clinton, and you know
that created a problem to him.
No, but it is for TDP to please look into it and disown these people because this is not good for democracy.
Mm.
Unfortunately, Hyderabad city, we have never seen such attacks.
Mm.
Maybe certain parts of Rayalaseema we have had these killings and counter killings. Yes. But we are safe. We are not seeing this. And
leaders are safe, but not the public.
No, sir. Public, yes. You're right. But this factional kind of killing never took place.
It is not there.
And it took a lot of strength on my part to stop from retaliating. I said, no, nothing doing. We'll not do anything.
Mm.
We'll go to courts. The courts will decide.
Mm.
And despite people accuse me of being very weak, being quiet, I said, no, I don't believe in this way. I don't believe in violence. And no one can have more pain than me because Akbar is my brother end of the day. But we have, should not allow this culture of violence to take roots in Hyderabad. Everyone should, we can disagree with political parties. It is very healthy for democracy. But how can we use violence? That is very wrong because once you open that door, we cannot close that door.
Yes, exactly.
That is a very dangerous thing. We have to be together to crush these people. These violent people, who they should not come near us. That is at least I hope that.
But I am told that in Chandrababu area, he is gaining popularity, Pailwan. Am I right?
People will decide, sir, in 2014 only.
Just I am asking.
No, no, I don't know, sir. I don't agree with that. I don't believe in that.
Okay.
Because people will never like a person who has indulged in such sort of gross and ghastly violence. People will never like them.
కానీ ఇంకొక క్రిటిసిజం ఏంటంటే మీ బ్రదర్స్ మీద కానీ మీ ఫాదర్ ఉన్నప్పుడు కూడా మీరేమో యువర్ పాలిటిక్స్ ఆర్ డిపెండింగ్ ఆన్ ఓల్డ్ సిటీ బట్ మీరు న్యూ సిటీలో ఉంటారని యువర్ లివింగ్ ఇన్ న్యూ సిటీ
సార్ చంద్రబాబు నాయుడు లివ్స్ హియర్ అండ్ కంటెస్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ కుప్పం జగన్మోహన్ రెడ్డి లివ్స్ హియర్ అండ్ కంటెస్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ కడప యూ నాట్ ఆస్కింగ్ దెమ్ దిస్ క్వశ్చన్ అట్లీస్ట్ ఐ లివ్ ఇన్ సిటీ అండ్ ఇన్ 10 మినిట్స్ ఐ రీచ్ యువర్
సిటీ
దిస్ ఇస్ రాంగ్ క్వశ్చన్ సార్
దిస్ ఇస్ నాట్ మై క్రిటిసిజం బట్ ఇట్ ఐ హవ్ బీన్ హియరింగ్ దిస్ క్వశ్చన్ ఫర్ ద పాస్ట్ ఫ్యూ డికేడ్స్
నో సార్ Our party was started in revived in 57 when we were living in Old City in the Pisalbanda area. This is a very wrong argument to give. And if that is the case, no political leader, if Manmohan Singh can contest from Assam and be Prime Minister, I am in city only. I am 15 minutes away from my constituency. That is a wrong allegation.
Okay. A good comparison. Okay. And a beautiful justification also.
Yes. Right justification.
So, coming to Telangana.
Yes, sir.
Why you are opposing Telangana?
Our stand is very clear, sir, that we are for united Andhra. We are saying if you want to divide state, then create a royal Telangana. Third and most important point, we are not for Hyderabad being made a union territory. The reason being that, unlike Chandigarh, Hyderabad has no geographical contiguity with Punjab and Haryana. And there will be so many issues for Hyderabad. We have to get water from coastal Andhra and Telangana. Who will fight, sir?
Yes.
What? See, people are unfortunately saying Hyderabad is the main issue. No, Hyderabad is not the main issue. The main issue is division of water.
Yes, that is the main issue.
Division of water. And one cannot say, no, we will form another central water commission or like tribunal. That, no one will be able to do it.
That will not solve the problem.
Even now. But now we have given our final opinion. It is for the government of India and the Congress party to take a call on it. This is our decision. Fourth point, sir, is if Telangana is created, you mark my words, TDP will become irrelevant because of what it is. It's not Telangana party. TRS will become irrelevant because it's a one-point agenda. Who will fill this political vacuum? Please tell me. TDP's core base in Telangana's OBCs.
Yes, OBCs.
TRS mix OBC and
everything. Exactly.
Now, this political vacuum cannot be filled by MIM party or by our communist friends.
100%.
This will automatically shift towards BJP. So, the net gainer,
will be the
political
BJP.
Gainer, whether it will lead to formation of government, but one thing is for sure, the net gainer and strengthening of BJP will happen over here. Let people in power decide this. I am not. See, if BJP gains strength, fine. I will also gain strength. I will not keep quiet.
Yeah, of course.
I will not keep quiet. You see,
one side gaining BJP means
automatically
MIM also gain.
No, I will not keep quiet because if Sangh Parivar is gaining, I will have to also gain because end of the day, no one comes to protect me at that particular point of time. It is for them to decide, whoever is deciding it. This is the reality. You might disagree with me, but no one is able to answer my question. If TDP and TRS goes, this vacuum will be filled by whom? Who will fill this vacuum? Please answer this question.
What was the answer from Congress Delhi leaders?
I didn't get an answer from any one of them. I didn't get answer from even people who are asking for Telangana. People who are asking Telangana, they have come and told me. I have respect for. I told them, look, this is my stand. That if you want to create Telangana, then create a Royal Telangana. We have given in writing. I don't want to keep on.
Even Royal Telangana, the same problem. Which
one?
The same problem. BJP will gain the Royal Telangana also.
It might, but at least there will be a counterbalance. There will be a counterbalance to it. But end of the day, it is now, I think so, it's high time that a decision has to be taken.
KCR, you said KCR?
KCR, no sir, I didn't interact with him for a long time. The last time I met him was in Parliament. Last session, we had a cup of tea. We shook hands and we said, how are you? Presenters exchange. But I now I'm saying this, this is not the first time I have put forward this argument. I have said it many times in many public forums, in public meetings. And this has been again proven in Mahbubnagar election.
Yes.
Mahbubnagar election, TRS Muslim candidate lost. What is the answer to it? Please tell me. When people are blaming me, please tell me this. What is the answer to it? So, anyway, this is...
Ahmed Patel to manchi rapo on the gada.
Sir, I have rapo with everyone. But I feel that a time has come now to take a decision. Please don't postpone it. Take a decision.
Whatever decision they take, me accept
just that. No, sir. See, decision has to be taken. Whatever comes, we'll decide when it comes.
The whole problem is that they are expecting that me andra support cheyalani.
Sir, unless and until a baby is born, how can you say it's going to be boy or girl? Baby has to be
baby
born.
Baby will not born from here.
No, whatever.
Somebody
it
has to conceive.
No, but sir, I'm sure you agree with me, because of this uncertainty, Hyderabad's image is suffering. State is suffering, uncertain, and the most biggest problem is, which really hurts me, is that so many students are committing suicide. These are youth, sir. They have a lot of life ahead of them.
Exactly.
And unfortunately, when a student commits suicide, 2 days, 3 days, all of us go.
Yes.
So after 7 days, no one goes there. Simple. What will happen to the hundreds of families?
Yes.
I don't think so. No one.
That is a really concerning issue.
That is what I'm saying. Yes. There has to be an end to this suicide, and a decision has to be taken in the larger interest of the country. Whatever decision you take, you must remember that this will have a national impact. Take a decision which is in national interest. Don't take a decision which is in your political interest. Take a decision which is in the nation interest, and then you arrive.
Okay, what is your indication?
I don't know, sir. My indication is as good as yours. I rely
You're
on
very good friends, Gada.
No, sir. See, sir, some friends are good. See, but thinking we don't know. No one shares the inner thinking. What we read in newspapers.
You have direct access to Madam Gandhi.
No, sir. I don't have a direct access to her. Let me reiterate. I have highest respect for her. And I continue to respect her because the amount of love she has given me and the respect she has shown me. But I don't know what is the thinking. I'm not as close as Chief Minister is close to her. Let me put it this way.
I got the point. So, CM ante baga ento undala anta undu meeku. So, inkokati one more thing entante, there were news entante, meeru on behalf of Jagan Mohan Reddy, you negotiated certain things with Congress High Command. Is it right?
No, wrong, sir. Wrong, absolutely wrong, absolutely rubbish. If I go and meet Jagan Mohan Reddy, I wanted to meet him for a long time. But that elections took place. If I went at that time, then media would have said he is going and supporting. Then CBI custody was there. Everything was over. And thirdly, if I had gone and met Jagan Mohan Reddy, who benefited out of it? Not me. Congress party benefited because he supported Parnab Mukherjee.
Yes.
And secondly, Parnab Mukherjee as a presidential candidate went and met Vijayamma.
Yes.
Why isn't that question being raised at that time? Of course, I went and met him. I went and requested.
No. We have raised the same question to Pranab Mukherjee also.
Yes. I don't know why this question is put to me. I went and met him. I requested him. And to his benefit, he immediately said, yes, I'll support it. I am not for communal politics.
In my view, Pranab Mukherjee should have not met. Sought the support. I am very clear as far as that aspect is concerned. Because at the time he was contesting for the highest post. Certain values and ethics and principles should be there for that post and person whom is aiming for that post.
I cannot comment on it, sir.
Of course. Because
he is the president of India now.
He is the president of India.
But anyway, he has met her and sought her support. as a candidate, I feel I don't feel that he did a wrong thing, but he went and met her and they supported him.
Okay, so when it comes to the AP politics, Dalit Mukhyamantri kavalani meer demand chestunnaru off late ga endukani
Dalit chief minister. No, we are saying that Muslims and Dalits should come together in a, on a political platform.
Okay, as one, then, as a front.
As a front, as even if political front does not happen, at least socially we should be together. Because our social issues, our educational issues, our economics are same. Harassment is the same. You take 121, which is being imposed on Akbar, waging war against India. In the whole history of usage of 121, I can give you, sir, very clearly, that 121 has always been used against Muslims, Dalits and tribals. Tribals for being Maoist, Dalits for being anti-national, Muslims for being anti-national. So that is what I'm saying, that there has to be a, at least a social platform wherein we take it forward. There, it is high time in Andhra
Pradesh. Only solution is political power.
Political power is very much important because we have seen people who have political power have progressed in life. They have got respect in life. Their way of life has changed. Their demands have been taken forward and accepted by the government. This is the need of the hour. It is, I know it is not easy. I can sit there and say, yeah, make course. Loud claims, but on the ground I have to work really hard.
Chala.
Maybe not in my lifetime it will happen. But I'm pretty much sure, inshallah, in my next in the next generation will not go through all this which we are going through right now.
Akbaruddin, I'm told that his marriage is love marriage.
Yes, sir. He married and he has kids now. Anyway, that's his personal life. And he's
other,
happy now.
Other religion, kada?
No, she is a Muslim now. She's a Muslim.
Of course, yeah. when he married her.
Yeah, it's a, he got married, so it's a personal life. Why should
no, personal. In the kind so, atana as it is, Akbaruddin is not a fundamentalist. What I mean to say is that.
No, sir. What is the meaning of fundamentalist too? If I pray 5 times a day.
No, that is not fundamentalism.
Good. So then Akbar is not a fundamentalist. If that is the case, he's not a fundamentalist then.
No, but it's not giving, not respecting others' religion, nor intolerance levels, all those
cannot,
things.
It cannot be. We know that diversity is the strength of our country.
Yes.
Diversity is the strength of our country. And we have to ensure that this diversity exists. And our country will exist, will be strengthened, will go forward if we take and accept the diversity. Diversity has to be accepted and reflected in our behavior.
Yeah, it has to be.
Oh yes, certainly.
Because
certainly.
That is the strength of country
only. Oh yes.
Unity in diversity.
Yes, sir. Yes. Sir.
But how many children you have?
Sir, I have six children. I have 5 daughters and 1 son.
What are they doing?
They are studying now in school. Oh, my school. Daughters are in, they're studying in the school now, yes.
Anybody in line in, to enter into politics?
No.
They are still kids.
Two are good enough, sir, for Andhra Pradesh.
True Owaisi, sir.
True are now it's nationally, every channel is carrying Owaisi, Owaisi, Owaisi. So two are good enough.
You don't want any more two.
Let them be happy, sir. Let them be happy. Let them enjoy their life.
Okay.
Let them do whatever they want. And our main intention is that they should become good human beings. Good human beings. And God is there.
So your wife, who is housewife only?
Yeah, she's a housewife. And yes.
What kind of food or what is your personal habits?
Sir, with food, I studied abroad. So I have learned one thing in life. One should never be picky about food.
Okay.
Whatever you get, thank God.
Whatever it is available.
Whatever is available. Whether if it is glass of water also, you thank God and say, thank you God, you have given me water and that's it. I am like that.
Okay.
Because I am not, you're not picky fond of and food choosy though. About food, nothing, sir. As long as I get small amount of food, I'm happy with that. That's it. Nothing. I am never picky or choosy with food. I always thank God that He has given me something to eat.
Okay.
That's God enough with me. And we politicians, we cannot really be.
So, me political career lo, what was your bitter experience?
Sir, so far there has never been a bitter experience. You face obstacles in political life.
Obstacles are different. Humiliations are something like that.
Obstacles are there. It is, every obstacle is an experience. Challenge to you. It is an experience. It's an opportunity for you.
Yes, that to learn.
It grows you. It makes your personality more stronger. It makes you learn. And then you learn from your mistakes.
Yes, definitely.
So far, I don't know. But for me, when you say a sad moment in my life is to lose my father.
Mm.
I don't think so. I can ever overcome losing him as a son.
Of course, he's a towering personality also.
I think so. I'll take this grief with me to my grave. That was the most sad part of my life, to lose my father. As a son, I still grieve for him. And I am sure every son will grieve for his father till he lives in this world.
Okay, memorable experience?
Memorable experience, many memories, sir. I cannot pinpoint one. Mm. And I'm sure there'll be more memorable experience to come in 2014 also.
So your ultimate goal is only 2014?
Not ultimate goal, one of the goals. Right now, that is the goal I'm going towards.
Mm.
And I'm sure in life you have more goals, because you reach a stage, then you say, okay, now this is another challenge to me. So as of now, that is the challenge to me, that I have to rise up and work hard. But I'm sure there will be more good memories, happy memories, bad memories in life, because life is full of good and bad things, you know, and you have to face these challenges of life.
Receive equally.
Oh yes, so be magnanimous and fight, that's it.
So political aim entante, whether it is a Royal Telangana or Andhra, United Andhra.
Yes.
Chief Minister Kavalananda?
Chief Minister?
Kavalanunda, you want to become Chief Minister?
No, sir. Mm. I have told many times to all these people that we are foot soldiers. We will continue to be foot soldiers. I am happy being that.
Mm.
Sir, God has been so kind to me. He has given me a lot of respect, a lot of love from people. I don't think so the amount of affection I enjoy personally, I don't think so even a Chief Minister will enjoy that. I am very happy in that.
Mm.
What will post will matter to me. For me, my struggle is important. My political struggle is important.
Mm.
Post will not help me. I don't want those posts.
Okay, even in Delhi also?
No, sir. You take it from me. I don't want anything.
Mm.
If Mohammad Ali Shabbir is made the Chief Minister, I will be the happiest person.
Okay.
If Fariduddin becomes a minister, I will be the happiest person. Yusuf Ali becomes, I will be the happiest person. If any Dalit becomes, I will be the happiest person. I am a foot soldier.
Okay.
I will always be there on the ground, fighting for the people.
You want to be kingmaker?
No, sir, not even kingmaker. Kingmaker, or you know, these are very, very strong terms. I am a foot soldier.
The first phase, you want to expand the party.
Certainly, sir. Certainly expand.
So, once you succeed in that, in expanding the party, automatically you become the kingmaker.
Whether we become or not, that's a different thing. But as far as person, when you ask me an individual personal question, I don't want any posts and ministers.
Mm.
But my party has to grow. Yes, certainly will grow. We want to become, important and instrumental in Andhra politics. Mm. That every political party would like to do that.
Mm. So, my best friend ever? Best friend?
Friends are lot of friends, right?
Normally, we will be having one or two with
whom
we can share everything.
No, sir. I have many childhood friends who are not in public sphere, but who continue to support me, who continue to pray for me, and
who continue to share.
No, sir. I cannot name one or two. It will be doing injustice to,
to others.
Others. And there are many.
All public school, HPS students.
No, HPS, Nizam College, and other. In political life also, despite being in different parties, they still understand, we understand their pain, we share their happiness.
Okay.
So, yes, friendship is there and will continue to be there. And because of my love and prayers of my friends, and I'm here.
Okay, final, what is your life goal?
Sir, I want to be, I'm trying to be a good human being.
Yep.
I'm trying to be a good human being. It is trying to be a good Muslim. That is what it is. This is a great inner struggle. It's a continuous struggle is there. You know, you try to...
A real good Muslim means a good human being.
Certainly, sir. Certainly. Of course. Certainly.
What Islam teaches and preaches.
Certainly, sir. I totally agree with you. Totally agree with you.
So, I wish you a good human being.
Thank you. Oh, yes.
Thank you very much.